Good morning, class. Let's now listen the line-to-line description of the poem, The Laburnum Top. So, good morning, everyone. I hope you all are doing well. You and your families are good. Stay happy, stay healthy, and do a lot of hard work. Improve your immunity. And also, I want to say one thing. The human mind is like a parachute. It only works when it is open. So open your mind, listen to the poem very carefully. I hope you all have listened to the summary. And now let's move on to the line-to-line description of the poem. Okay. So I'm going to read the lines for you and then I'm going to describe them. The Laburnum top is silent, quiet, still in the afternoon yellow September sunlight. A few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen, till the goldfinch comes with twitching chirrup and suddenness, a startlement, and at a branch, and then sleep as a lizard at a lot and abrupt. She enters the thickness, and a machine starts up for offsetting and promoter of wings and trilling. The whole tree trembles and thrills. As I have told you in the summary, a goldfinch bird comes to the end, the death-like scene of a tree, and makes a sudden chirrup sound. So before the coming of the goldfinch bird, the tree was standing completely silent because it was the September autumn season and the tree was receiving a lot of sunlight and becoming golden yellow due to that, and all its leaves were becoming yellowish and they were being fallen down from the tree. And the bird came and enters the thick branch of the tree, and all of a sudden a lot of sound, chirping of birds was there, as the younger ones in the nest, those who were waiting for their mother to come and feed them, they started chirping and doing vibrations with the wings. So the bird, while being rapid, alert. See, here the poet tells about the bird that she is alert like a lizard, that she was completely watching the surroundings, that her younger ones are safe or not. So precautions like a lizard sits on the branches of a tree as she moved towards the thickness of the branch. Her younger ones started chirping and doing vibrations with the wings, making a sound like machine because of the movement of the bird and her younger ones. The tree starts to shake and thrill. Here see the beauty of the life that the poet has described. Like earlier, the tree was stood silent like a death-like scene. As soon as the bird came, her younger ones started chirping, and the whole tree was shaking with thrill and tremor. So the poet has given two opposite scenarios of the tree. First, being death-like and still, then giving life and shelter to the bird and her young ones. See the comparison the poet has given, that earlier the tree was completely silent and still. It was not at all having, it looks like that no life was there. But as soon as the goldfinch bird came, the shelter of the bird and her young ones was there. They were having the nest over there, and all of a sudden the tree becomes alive. Now it is the engine for her family. She stokes it full, then flirts out to a branch end, showing her buried face identity mask. So now see, the Laburnum tree and the goldfinch bird is the engine of her family. As the nest was on the Laburnum tree and the mother bird, they were the engine of the family. She provides food to her young ones and moves to the other branch, and her dark colored striped face is visible as her body is yellow colored and the yellow leaves of the tree. Okay. Now, then with airy, delicate whistle chirrup, whispering, she launches away towards the infinite and the laburnum subsides to empty. Now, here comes the ending, like when the bird comes out of the nest, comes out of that thick branch and sit at the end of the branch, and she chirrup very slowly. Whisperings means very slowly. And then she flies away to the infinite sky, and again the laburnum tree stood still there, and it was standing over there still. No sound was there, because before that the goldfinch bird was showing her face to her younger ones. It was the identity mask for the kids, and they were very happy to see the mother. And then when the mother flew away to the sky, they were completely silent, and again it was a complete silence on the tree. So after reaching the end of the branch, the bird makes a sweet chirping sound, just like whispering, and flies away towards to the infinite sky as I described. And it again makes the laburnum tree silent and death-like, because the life is again flying away from the tree, and when the goldfinch bird comes back, the tree will become alive again. So I hope you all have understood. So be very careful, listen carefully, and I want everybody to please send me either on my personal chat. You all have to send me a thumbs up as you have seen the lecture. That will be marked as your attendance. Otherwise, your absent will be marked. So please be very careful for that. Hoping that you will be responding positively. So all the best. Listen carefully. Good. All the best for your PT1. And thank you so much for listening.